right, Chris and I are out here on our pasture, and we have been looking at rotational grazing for our calves, and we talked about doing it on the other side of the house down there, but there's two problems. One is the creek, and one is the gate that goes out to that pasture is broken, and a third is that they're going to mow again this year, and so we're thinking maybe, since we want to plant orchard up here anyway, we can bring the calves in and have them graze this area. And so we went online and we looked at, Chris, tell me about a little bit about that website that we were looking at. What is it to calculate?
Sure, it calculates the size of your paddock based on how much dry matter you have per acre in pounds, and the size of your beeves, and those types of things. You input the variables and it tells you, you know, if you want to do one shift every 7 days, or, you know, however you want to set it up. It's a really great document, and I'll post a link to it in the comments on this video.
So based on the size that our calves are now, which is 300 pounds, and that I only want to move them once every 7 days, I don't want to do anything more intensive than that. And my reasoning is because I travel for work 1 week out of every month, and I don't want my mom or the kids having to move calves between paddocks while I'm gone and messing with the hot wires and all that. So based on the size they are now, we can do in 1 acre 4 paddocks. And we think we have enough right here, but I was thinking as we walked out here, Chris, that we didn't calculate the fact that they're going to grow so that they're 300 pounds now, but by fall they're going to be 700, 900 pounds. So we're going to measure out here between this gate and our house area and see if we've got enough to set up here. Another reason it would be convenient here is because we have electrical already right here in the chicken coop and shed. So it'd be easy just to run a extension cord up through the rafters and set our little controller somewhere here. Whereas on the other side, we actually have to run it down a hill through a pasture, and we'd have to end up putting it underground or something to get it out there. So, ready to get to measuring?
Yeah, we're going to see if we got a little more than 1 acre out here. So, if that's the case, we'll be able to divide this up into 3, maybe 4 sections, depending on how far we can get. We don't want to... There's a trench right there at the telephone pole where the power for our house is going in. So we need to stay on this side of that. So that's going to be our limiting factor.
Right. All right, let's go measure. Tell me, what are the benefits of rotational grazing?
Some of the benefits of rotational grazing, mainly it's going to enrich the soil fertility, because the cows aren't going to stay in one area long enough to compact the soil, which then facilitates weed growth. They're going to be dropping nutrient and then moving from one cell to the next as we shift them. And then this nutrient becomes interactive with the existing soil life, which is then gonna show itself in a better hay crop.
So I built a little mount to work with the energizer. We're in the chicken coop right now, trying it out in different mounting locations. And we start off low, then went up higher with it, thinking, okay, the chickens wouldn't roost on it if we put it up here. And that didn't really work out, so we moved into the outer coop area, trying it on a post and then over on a beam. We finally end up in the equipment shed. So let's take a look at how this thing got mounted up and how it works.
Yeah, we'll go down. We could put the ground rods in here, or I think better would be outside.
Okay.
And the hot and the ground could both run out and under here.
Okay.
And then they can run along the outside edge of the building under a pile of rocks or whatever.
So
where
so
we need
it. It won't be in the way of lawn mowing and stuff. All right, let's go around behind this and take a look.
Sounds good.
This is that corner that you're talking about. The wires could come out right here.
Yeah.
The thing we do need to be aware of is chickens coming in out the store when we have a chick brood in the other side of the
right.
coop. The older ones are coming out this way. But like you said, if we just bring up rocks, it looks like we have a stack of pavers right there.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're doing anything in there.
They could just lay over it.
Lay
real
over
easy.
It out here. here where you can attach your T-pole or whatever.
Yeah, we'll set like a T-pole here.
Okay.
This will divide off this first section.
Okay.
And then we'll run out.
Alright, so in there's probably the best place for it. Okay, so what do we need to do first?
First thing we need to do, let's get power over to this area where we want to put the controller.
Okay. I'm going to get up there, if I can, and give a little snip or pull out the edge of the chicken wire a little bit and put the end of this eccentric clip through, and then we'll bring it down from the other side. Assuming I can reach. Chris, feel steady the ladder for me. Alright, can you hand me the end? Don't even have to cut anything. Just a matter of if I can get it up and over. Leslie, hold the ladder.
Oh, she startled me.
I got my foot on the ladder.
There we go.
Alright, Mom. See the 2x4 there?
Yeah, I do.
All right. Push hard. There you go. All right. Good job.
Now the mounting location is picked out. Join us for part 2 as we get the energizer set up and the ground rods in place.